Moving on to the second part, after the first part, we looked at what a five-wave structure with a third wave extension is. Remember, as a reminder, if you want, the third wave needs to be 161.8 when compared with the length of the first one. And then after the fifth wave goes and takes the highs in the third wave, which is not mandatory, by the way, but this is happening most of the times, then that is the place we should go and buy put options if the impulsive move is bullish, or call options if the impulsive move is bearish. Now, what to look in this US dollar Canadian dollar pair? Well, the US dollar Canadian dollar, from my point of view, forms an impulsive move after a contracting triangle that broke higher here. So this would be the contracting triangle that broke higher, like this. And like this. And normally at this moment of time, we should look for a five-way structure after the triangle, remember, broke higher. Well, if the triangle broke higher, I would say that the structure here goes with this being one, the first wave, the second wave, the third wave, which is extended. Remember, it needs to be more than 161.8. The fourth wave to be done here, right after, right with the start in 2015. And then the fifth wave all the way to the upside here. So what do we have? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, a clear principle of alternation with different legs in the second and the fourth wave. And this should be the first wave. This should be the second wave here. This should be the third wave. This should be the fourth wave. This should be the fifth wave. Now, remember what we've discussed. After the fifth wave goes almost in the same length like the first wave, normally we should go and buy put options in such a move, because what? Because of this, because price should retrace to the end of the third wave after such a move. It means, if you project this one on the right side here and you look at the levels, it means it should come into 116.70 area, when market was actually at the 1.1840, and therefore something like more than 100 and something pips. And this is again quite good. The expiration date, by the time this level came, could have been anything. Could have been end of day expiration date. Could have been end of week, depending on the horizon and on risk appetite, and even lower values, as the market really moved lower from that moment on. Thank you for being here. This is Fair Binary Options.com. We just looked at third wave extension of the US dollar Canadian dollar. Now, it remains to be seen, if on the US dollar Canadian dollar price goes and confirms this one. If this is an impulsive move, then 1.17 is a must. Thank you and bye-bye.